Now we are moving towards the operators of your VB .NET. So there are a few types of operators, that is your arithmetic operators, comparison means relational operators, logical operators, bit shift operator means your bitwise operator, and assignment operators. Other than that also there are operators, we all are aware about the operator and what is the use of operator. So the operators are used for performing the operations on the operands. Okay. So here it is some examples of arithmetic operators. So that is your power of operator, addition operator, subtraction operator, multiplication, division, and division operator. So in division operator there are two ways. If you want a floating point or double value, then you have to use your forward backslash, and if you want to integer value, then you can use backslash or slash, we can call it as. So okay, so and the last one is a modulus. So power up means if you want to give a power to the any value, then it will use as a power up operator. So the assume variable A has value 2 and assume variable B has value 7. So 7 to the power 2 means it gives a value as a 49. 7 plus 2 means it gives a value as a 9. 7 minus 2 minus 7, it gives value as a minus 5. A into B means 7 into 2 is it gives a 14. Then B divided by A means 7 divided by 2 will give as a 3.5 value. And if you are using a backslash, then 7 divided by 2 will be output as a 3. So depend on your need. If you want a floating value, then you can use this slash, forward slash, and if you are using want integer value, then you can use backslash also. Or modulus operator, mod operator, that is your B mod A, it will give output as a 1. Okay, so these are the arithmetic operators we are using. After that, some comparison operators are there. So comparator operators means you are equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to. So all are aware about these operators. What is comparison operator? It gives a value in the form of true or false, boolean value. Okay, so if the variable values are equal, then it will give true. If not equal, it will give a false value. If you are using greater than, so A is greater than B, if A value is greater than B, then it will give as a true. If not, then it will give as a false. Same for less than, less than equal to, greater than equal to. So these are the relational operator which we will use in a conditional statement or your looping statements. We can use in the form of conditions. Okay, then some logical operators are there, and or not. So if the both the conditions, if you want to merge some conditions, so we can use and or operators so that we can get a output, exact output. So if the both the conditions are true, then it will give only a true and operator, otherwise it will give a false. Or means if any one of the condition from A or B is true, then it will give as a true. Not operator, it reverses the value, means if it is true, then it gives output as a false, and if it is false, then it gives the output as a true. Okay, then bit shift operator means your bitwise operators. So here it is a truth table for your bitwise operator. So 00 in the form of bits 00 01 11 and 10 are the values of P and Q. If you are performing AND operation on P and Q, so both the values are 0 means it gives the output as a 0. If one of the value of P or Q is 1 or 0, it always gives as a 0. And if the both the values are 1, then it will only give a 1. Means like a true and false. If you consider as a 0 as a false, then false false it gives a false. False true it gives again a false. Again true true it gives as a true. And true false it again gives as a false value. Same for the OR operator. OR operator only gives a 0 value when both the values are 0. otherwise it will give as a 1. If one of the value is 1, then it will give as a 1. And XOR means both the values, if both the values are same, then it will give as a 0, and if both the values are different, then it will give as a 1 output. So some operations are there, left shift and right shift. If you want to shift the bits of the variable, so we can convert the decimal value into binary value, and we shift that binary values by some bits. So here it is a syntax for A is left shifted by 2. So the value of binary A is 00111111 and 00. So you can shift that 2 bits from left, and we can add 2 bits from right. So in the left we can see that two zeros are there. So these two zeros are removed, and these all bits are shifted to left by 2, and two zero bits are added to the right side. So it will give the value as a 111100, and 2 again added as a 0. Then right shift for a operator. If a value is 60, the binary of 60 is 00111100, and if you right shift that 2, then it will remove the 2 bits from the right side, and it will add 2 bits at the left side. So it will shift all these bits in the direction of right. So it will give the output as a 00 and 001111. Okay, so these are the operations performed by the bit shift operators. Assignment operators, equal to operator is your assignment operator. It can be used with the arithmetic or operators also, means your plus equal to, minus equal to, multiply equal to, division equal to, division equal to. So you can use the operator, assignment operator, with your arithmetic operator also. So the outputs examples are given as a C is equal to A plus B. Will assign the value of A plus B to C. C. So right value is assigned to the left side value. Okay. So here it is C plus equal to A is equivalent to C equal to C plus A. So here all the examples are given with the assignment operator and arithmetic operators. So these are the assignment operators we will use. So depend on that operator, we will perform some operations or we will perform some examples of your VB Visual Studio. So I will share the screen, and we will do one program for arithmetic operator. Okay. Wait for a second. So I will share entire screen. Okay, so here it is your Visual Studio 19. So what we have to do, we have to create one console project, because this is not a your Windows form application. We have to done your arithmetic operations. So we have to use console application. So click on create a new project. Then I will use a default as Visual Basic Windows console application. We can use this console application with the .NET framework. Double click or next, click next on the. So here I am not giving any project name or location, it is by default assigned. So I am creating that console application with next. Wait for a second to create a project. After creating, we will write a code for taking a input values, different types of values, and we can perform some arithmetic operation, and we will display that output on a console screen. Okay. So in yesterday's lecture, we have studied about the variable declaration. We have studied about the variable declaration, how we can declare the variables. Okay, so here I am creating declaring some variables, and for declaring the variable we have a keyword as a dim. So x as integer, then dim, and then y as integer. So I am creating two integer values, and dim z as double value. Okay, so I am creating here a double value.
Sir, it is n.
Oh, okay. Okay, so here I am creating created three variables x, y, and z. Now I have to assign a value to x, y, and z. So I am giving a value as x is equal to 10, simple value, y is equal to 20, and no need to give semicolon. Okay, so performing arithmetic operation is equal to z is equal to x plus y. Okay, again, okay, so this is your arithmetic operation, z is equal to x plus y, and we will print this output on a console. So console dot, what may we use, write line and give a values as x is equal to, I want to print the value of x also, y also, and z also. So here as a axis modifier, we can call it as modifier, we are using as a zero, okay, in a curly braces for extracting the value from this variable. So what variable we are using, that variable value is extracted to this. In C programming, we have uses as a percent %d, percent %f, percent %s, percent %c. So here it is used as a zero value. Okay, zero means first value. If you use one, then it is second value. If you use two, then it is third value. So for x, I am giving as a zero, and for y, I am giving as a one, and for z, I am giving as a 2. Okay, so these are the positions for the variables. Okay, here I am giving a variable names as x on a 0 position, then y on a first position, and z on a third position. So these are the positions for your x, y, and z. So this x is on 0 position, it will give output to the 0. Y on a first position, it will give output in a 1. And z on a second position, so it will give output as a z. Okay, then for holding your console screen, we have to use some write line function or read line function. Sorry, we can hold the screen now. Okay, so here it is a simple example of arithmetic operation, addition of two numbers. So we will run this program, so you can see the output of this program. After that, we will give as a user input. Here I am giving, assigning a initialize a value at the time of compilation, but I want to give a values as a user input. After this example, I will give as a, so it is output showing as x is equal to 10, y is equal to 20, and z is equal to 30. So value of x is 10, value of y is 20, and value of z is x plus y, means 10 plus 20 is 30. So it is a simple example for your arithmetic operation. If you perform same like this as, or we can copy this statement, paste again it as minus y, and again we are printing same values. Okay, so it is x value is 10, y value is 20, now z value is minus 10, because 10 minus 20 is minus 10. So for each and every operation, you can do the same. Okay, so this is the basic example for taking values directly from declaration or initialization and printing the output on the screen. So now what we have to do, we have to take an input from user. Okay, we have to take a input from user. For that I am giving a message Let's check it for X. Okay. Console printing one message on the console screen. Right line. So in right line, I am giving a one message. Enter the number. First number. Then console. So for reading the value, we can use read line also, or we can use okay, read line. So for storing the value into the x, x is equal to read line. Let's check for the x first, then we will go for the y. So here enter the first number, so I am entering here as a 12, and you will get a output as x is equal to 12, y is equal to 20, so it is by default 20, and z is equal to 32. So x plus y is 32, and the 12 minus 20 is minus 8. So it is taking an input for x. Now I am giving an input for y. Okay, so delete this, give as a y, enter second number. Okay. Run the application. So enter first number, then enter second number as 34, and the output is your 12, 34, and 46. So here it is an example for reading a data from your console screen. Everyone understood what we have to do? Two functions we have to use. First one is write line for writing a data, means like your printf. Okay, like your printf or cout, we can write a statement on the console. And like scanf or your cin, you have to use read line, and whatever the values are readed by read line, it will store into the variable. It is string value or character value or integer value, all the values are accepted by your read line function. So that value will be assigned to the variable, and it will calculate as this expression, or we can call it as arithmetic operations perform here. So z is equal to x, y, and again we will print a value on a output screen. So for the modifiers we will use as a curly bracket and the index number. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, for depend on the position of variable. Okay, so this is the basic example for your arithmetic operation. It is included in your practical also. So I will show you. I think this I already told you about the message box in the last session. Is it yes or no? Message box. And now we have performed the solve arithmetic expression. Okay, so third practical also completed. So write it in your practical book. Then we have to perform develop a program, demonstrate use of if else and control structure. Okay, so we will move forward toward if else and your control structures. Okay, so assignment operator. After that The next part is your decision making statements. That is your if statement, if then else statement, nested if statement, and select case system statements. So select case means your switch statement. Okay, in your C or C++, you are aware about the switch statement. Here it is a select case statement. The working of a select case statement is same as a switch statement. Only the name and syntax is different in the Visual Basic. Again, for if and if then else is also same as if and else in the C programming or C++. Again, nested if else also same concept. Only the syntactical change is in the Visual Studio. We will see how to write the if and else statement, also nested if else statement, switch case, and other nested switch case means your select case. So first your if case. So if then means your only if. Simple if, we will call it as a simple if. So it is a if statement. So syntax for if statement is your if then test condition is there, and the keyword is then. Statement means your block of statement. There is no opening curly bracket and there is no closing curly bracket. Only this start of if is a opening curly bracket considered as a in a VB.NET. And end if means you are closing curly bracket. Okay, in that statements, whatever the statements you are writing in this code, so that statement will be executed when the condition is true. So if condition, then keyword, and then statements of the whatever the operation you are performing in the if statement. So here it is an example of if then if statement. So if a condition is A is less than equal to 20, then what we have to perform, C is equal to C plus 1 is the operation and end of if. So this is your example of if statement, simple if statement. So we will see our example, we will run an example on a if statement first. So I am using this same example. What only change is there? We are taking a value of x and y, and we will calculate which value is greater and which value is smaller. Okay, so here we are checking for if. So after if we have to give a condition. What is condition? Is if x is greater than y or not. Okay, if x is greater than y, it will show as a true. If x is not greater than y, then it will give as a false. So next keyword is your then keyword. Okay, after that automatically it takes as a end if. Okay, so this is your if block. Whatever the statements you are writing inside the if block, that will execute when only x is greater than y. Okay, so the value of x is greater than y, then only the statements are executed, otherwise it will skip that block. Okay, so I will write some statement. I will copy this. I will write some statement as x is equal to the zero position value. X is greater than y. Okay, and the y value is on a first position. I am giving as a x comma y. So these are the both the values, and we have to print this statement. Okay, so console write line, then your x and y, and for holding the output we have to write again the console dot read key or read line, whatever the function you are using, no problem at all. Okay, so is greater than y. This is only if block, so only we are using a true condition. If true condition is not there, then the console will not show any message. Okay, so run the application first. It is asking for a first number, so I am giving as a 14 is the first number and the second number is 12. Okay, enter. So x14 is greater than 12. This message is showing as a x14 is greater than 12. So it is correctly executed if statement. So if value of first number is greater than second number, only this message will be displayed. Otherwise, I'm running again. Otherwise, if you are putting a first value as a small and second value as a greater than first number, then it will not show any output. So I pressed already enter, but it will not show any value. Okay. So for that drawback, we have to write else statement. Okay. For removing that drawback, we have to write else statement. That is your false block. So we will go to the slides. So the next one is your if then else. Okay, so this is your if then else. So what is the syntax for if then else? If boolean expression then it is consist of else block, means it is a true block and it is a false block for this condition. If condition is true, then this block will be executed. If the condition is false, this block will be executed. So we will go to the program and we will add only one statement here as else. Okay, so it automatically converts into if and else block. So same program converted as x1 is smaller than y. Okay, same program. What I have did is only added a else block. Okay, end will be here. So start of if statement, then if is condition is false, then it will goes to the else block and it will show as a output. So run the code, enter the first number as 14, enter the second number as 12, whatever the number you want you can enter. So x is equal to 14 is greater than y. Statement is correct. Okay, so we will check the next condition for smaller number. So I am putting a first number as 12, putting a second number as 14, and x12 is smaller than 14. So both the conditions are now executing properly. Okay, everyone understood the concept. What I am doing is if and else block. So first of all, I have executed your first block, that is your if block. And after that, the drawback is overcome by your else block. So whatever the drawback is, only true condition will check. But when you are adding else block, it will check true and false condition, both condition for the block of your statements. Okay, everyone understood? Yes or no? Okay, so we will move towards next your. So it is a nested if else. No, it is a else if ladder. Okay, it is a else if ladder. So ladder means what? Checking the multiple conditions. It is a ladder. So if boolean expression 1, then else, again if boolean expression 2, again else if boolean expression 3, again if, again else. So up to the last else we can use. Okay, so we will check these examples also. So this is a select case example. We will check for a ladder first. Okay, so we will convert this example as with the three variables. Okay, dim z as integer and again we will write a code for third value input. So console third number enter as a z. Okay, so we have a three numbers. Now we have to check the value of greatest number from first, second and third number. Okay, we have to print the value of greatest number. So when we are checking for first condition, if x is greater than and x is greater than z. Okay, so what will be the output is x is greater. Okay, x is greater. What we are doing, we are printing a maximum value from these three value. We are printing a maximum value from this three value. So we are checking a condition for x only first. After that, I am copying this with this as if else statement, entering it as y is greater than z and y is greater than x, then only the value of y is greater. Okay, we are finding the maximum value. So here we will print the value of y. Again, the same condition is for third one case. Third case is your for z. Z is greater than x and z is greater than y, then the value of z is greater. Okay, and the last one is for if all the values are equal, then we are giving a values are equal message. All values are equal. So are you understood this program? What we have to do? We have to find out the maximum number from the three numbers. We are using your ladder, if else ladder. Nested if means you can put the if block inside the if block, but here we are using an else if ladder. So in a first condition we have checked for x is greater, in a second condition we have checked for y is greater, and third condition is checked for z is greater. If this all the conditions are false, then last we will give a message as all values are equal. Okay, let's check the example. Enter the first number, so I am entering as a 13, 45 second number, and third number is 32. So the 45 is greater. Okay, the y value is greater. Y is 45 and 45 is greater. Again, check for the next for possible combination. So I am putting a value is 34, 23 and 12. So the 34 is greater. Again, x value is greater. Again, we will check for a third condition is for 12, 23 and 56. So 56 is greater, z value is greater, so third value is also check. Again, check for a last condition of equal numbers, so 12, 12 and 12. Okay, so all values are equal, so all the conditions are giving their output correctly. So this is the example for your if and if else and control structures. Whatever the control structure we are using, if else, if then else, if else ladder, you can use nested if else also inside the if. You can design a if else. So fourth practical is your develop program to demonstrate the use of if else control structure. So this is also practical done. Now the next one is develop program to demonstrate use of case control structure in VB.NET, means your select case. We will see the next one is select case. So for select case means switch case. Can anyone tell me what is switch case?
When the condition is satisfied or it is as it is equal to the cases, it will then those cases will open.
Okay. Any other answer?
It compares one value with multiple choices.
Okay, good. We can select a value from multiple choices. So if you have multiple choice, you can select any one value from that multiple choices. Okay, so that is your switch case, and the select case is also same as your switch case. So you can write a switch case means select case problem in your VB.NET also. So we will see how it is work. So it is a syntax for select case statement. So select case value means your we can call it as choice, select choice, and expression. Expression means the value, whatever the value you are taking as an input, okay, as a case input. Then case expression. So case expression list means case 1, case 2, case 3, then your statement, then case 2 statement, case 3 statement, case 4 statement. Here it is not any break statement, okay. It will automatically take as a break statement. So we will print the statement as so it is an example of your you can call it as a select statement. So we will run this program only. Okay, so here in this program we are calculate excellent, well done, you pass, better, try again, and invalid gate. So we are calculating a grade for a given inputted character. So we are inputting a one character, and depend on that character we can show a grade of the student, whatever the grade it is taken. Okay, so I am copying this program from dim to readline. Okay, I am testing this program here. I will explain this complete program, don't worry about that. Okay, so first of all, what we are doing, what we have done, we have did the grade variable as character. So it will take a character. We will take a character from user. Okay, no need to give a direct character here. So we will take a character as input console dot write line. In write line, what we have to do? Enter the grade. Enter the grade, and after that, what we have to take? We have to take an input from user. For that, we have to use console dot readline. We are using readline function. So, what is the grade value is given by the user? It will stored into the grade variable. Then the actual syntax of select case is your select case and the grade value means whatever the input is taken by the user or given by the user, it will store it into the grade that will pass to the select case. So here we will pass the grade. The grade will compare all these values, compare all these values with this case value. So here it is a grade value. Whatever the value entered by the user is compared to the case values. So if it is matched with the first value, then it will give output as excellent. If it is matched with the second or third value, it will give as output as a well done. So you can put two values in a one case. Okay, you can put a two values in a one case. So write line well done, then D match with the D, then you can give a excellent. Sorry, you pass grade. Then if it is matched with the F, then it can display a better try again, else otherwise the invalid grade. If the grade is not matched with any grade of above, so it will give a invalid grade as a output. So after the select case means your switch case, it will display a value of your grade is whatever the grade value is given into this grade value, it will display on the screen. Okay, and read line for holding your console screen. So we will execute this. Enter the grade. So I am here giving as a A grade first, and I got a excellent grade. Okay, excellent grade. Your grade is A. So it is a message from use. Again, I will check for a C grade. So I am giving as a input as a C grade. So it is well done. Your grade is C. So you can see this C and well done is the grade value. Okay. Again, I will give one for invalid grade. So I will give as a Z. So it is an invalid grade. Your grade is Z and it is invalid grade. So this type of statements you can run in your console application in your VB.NET. Okay, understood what is select case? Switch case means you have a multiple choice and you have to select any one choice from this multiple choice depending on your input. So when you are giving an input, you can select any input from the user and that input is compared with the all the cases. If you are taking input as a integer, then we have to give value as a integer only. Okay, if you are taking as a character, then you have to give value as a character. Okay, so this type of inputs you can give and you can compare the case and you can execute the case. Here there is no need of break statement. Automatically it close after this last statement. Whatever the last statement is there in the case, it will execute and it will exit from that case loop. Okay, so this is the case statement. So in a next we can show. So this is fifth practical program. You can see that develop program to demonstrate use of case control structure in VB.NET. So this is a case control structure. After that we have a develop program to demonstrate use of while and do loops in a VB.NET. So I think I don't have a slide for while loop. Okay, so what is loop? Can anyone tell me what is loop?
Loop is an iterative statement used to repeat several statements for a long time.
Okay, loop is a iterative statement means if you want to iterate any statement or conditionally iterate the statement or repeated the statement execution, then we have to use the loop. Okay, so we will see simple example about the loop. So we are aware about the for loop. What is for loop? What is while loop? Can anyone tell me when we use for loop and when we use while loop? There are two types of loops, your normal for loop and while loop, but both the loops are same. The working of loops are same, but when we use for loop, when we use while loop, this question may be asked in interviews. Most of the interviews it will ask as a, when we use for loop and when we use while loop.
For loop is used where condition and increment and initialization is required.
But in while loop also we need a condition, we use initialization, we need a increment decrement.
For loop is used when the end limit is not.
Okay, good. When for loop we will use if you are aware about the start and end of the loop. If you are aware about the start of the loop and end of the loop, then only we can use a for loop. And if we are not aware about the end of the loop, when we have to end the loop, then we will use as a while loop. Means agar aapko start and end pata hai, you can use for loop. अगर आपको स्टार्ट पता है लेकिन एंड पता नहीं कि कहाँ पे करना है, देन वी हैव टू यूज अ वाइल लूप. अगर रियल टाइम एग्जांपल कंसीडर किया जाए तो फॉर एग्जांपल अगर आपको 5 एलिमेंट्स प्रिंट करना है, मींस 1 to 5, सो आपको स्टार्ट भी पता है एंड भी पता है, सो आप वो फॉर लूप में डाल के 5 एलिमेंट्स प्रिंट कर सकते हो. वाइल में भी आप प्रिंट कर सकते हो, बट वाइल लूप कब यूज होता है? मोस्टली इन if you are not aware about the end of the loop. Means for example, if you want to extract the data from list, if you want to extract the data from list and us list ke andar kitne data hai hame pata hi nahi hai, us list ke andar kitna data hai pata nahi, kitne elements us list ke andar hai pata nahi hai, but hame list se data extract karna hai. Or file se hame data extract karna hai, file se hame data extract karna hai, uske andar kitne characters hai ye pata nahi hai, but hame end of the file tak ke एक्सट्रैक्ट करना है. सो हम तब क्या करेंगे, यूज करेंगे वाइल लूप। ओके, सो वाइल लूप एंड फॉर लूप का डिफरेंस पता रखो, जब इंटरव्यू देने जाओगे तो आपको क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता है मोस्टली। सो वी विल सी हाउ टू क्रिएट अ फॉर लूप इन योर वीबी डॉट नेट। सो हियर आई एम, ओके, इन अ सेम प्रोग्राम आई एम डूइंग द प्रोग्राम फॉर वाइल, सॉरी फॉर लूप। ओके, सो फॉर लूप व्हाट एवर द थिंग्स आर नीडेड, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड योर इंटीजर वैल्यू फॉर योर इंडेक्स वैल्यू एज इंटीजर, इंडेक्स वैल्यू, देन वी विल यूज डायरेक्टली व्हाट फॉर लूप। सो फॉर लूप वी आर यूजिंग फॉर, देन योर इंडेक्स वैल्यू, सो स्टार्ट ऑफ इंडेक्स वैल्यू इज फ्रॉम वन एंड अप टू वेयर वी हैव टू गो, अप टू फाइव वी हैव टू गो। ओके, अप टू फाइव वी हैव टू गो एंड व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इन टू द फॉर लूप, राइट कंसोल डॉट राइट लाइन, वी विल डू एज कंसोल डॉट राइट लाइन इन दैट वी विल प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ, फर्स्ट वी विल प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ आई ओनली, जीरो। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी विल प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ आई एंड नेक्स्ट इज एडेड इन टू द फॉर लूप फॉर कंटिन्यूइंग द लूप। वेन द कंडीशन इज फॉल्स मीन्स यूर वन इज गो अप टू द फाइव, देन इट विल स्टॉप योर लूप। ओके, सो फॉर एंड ऑफ द लूप आई कैन गिव एज अ कंसोल डॉट रीड लाइन और रीड की। सो लेट मी चेक व्हाट इज द आउटपुट फॉर दिस। ओके, सो इट इज शोइंग द वैल्यू ऑफ आई। नाउ यू कैन सी फर्स्ट इट स्टार्ट विद वन एंड एंड टू द फाइव। सो ऑन द फर्स्ट इटरेशन द वैल्यू ऑफ आई इज वन, इट विल प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ आई इज एज वन। After next, it will increase the value of I as 1 and 1 plus 1 is 2. Now the value of I is 2, it is less than 5 and we can go up to the 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and up to 5 we can execute the for loop. If you want to jump or if you want to print even numbers, so how we can give an even number loop? So for that what we have to do? Starting from even number means starting from, we can start from 2. Okay, and 2 up to 10 we have to print, and the steps we have to follow is up to 2, means we will add as a 2 not as a 1. By default it add as a 1, we are adding 2 because we want a even numbers only. So let's check for the example. So up to 10 it is printing 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So if you want to print a table for 2 means up to 20 it will print. Okay, output is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 and 20. So these are the even numbers, whatever the numbers we are want up to the some certain conditions, we can give a condition as per your need. So this is the even number. If you want to add or print odd numbers, you can give start from 1 and run the example as odd numbers. So it will give as odd numbers. Okay. So for today, it is sufficient for up to for loop. Next session, we will see about the while loop. Do while.